All right, in this one, I would like to talk about how you can handle directories in C, because we often talk about how you can handle files, but I've rarely seen a tutorial about directories, so here it is. But I mean, it's pretty similar to files anyway, but might as well show you. So the three main functions to manipulate directories are opendir, closedir, and readdir, and you can probably guess from the name what each of those does. So to use them, you will need to include those two headers, dir end and sys types. So if you want to open a directory, you do dir open like so, and you specify just the name of the directory. So in my case, I've pre-created a bunch of directory, and one of them is foo with a bunch of stuff in it. And it will give you a pointer to a directory, very similar to the file pointer. And to close it, you just do close dir and give it the dir pointer. This will deallocate the memory. And now for the more interesting part, you can iterate over each entry of the directory by creating a struct called dir end, which is a pointer. And then you can repeatedly call the readdir function on the directory pointer, and once readdir has read all the entries in the directory, it will return null, so it will stop when it's null. And each of the dir end directory entry contains some basic information about the directory. So there is the file type, so if it's a regular file, if it's a directory, if it's a character file, stuff like that, if it's another directory, if it's a block file, if it's a character file, stuff like that. It also stores the inode, so the actual the pointer on disk, let's say. Not a video about inode, so I won't detail. But basically, you can print, for example, just the name of the entry, so you say entry d name. Like so, and if you execute it, and it's open dir, not dir open. But if you execute it, you can see that it just went over all the files, the content in foo, and iterated over them. As you can see, it also includes the current directory and the parent directory, so you have to be careful. For example, I was rewriting the rm command at some point, and when I implemented the recursive option, I didn't take into account this, and I deleted, I think, well, a lot of files on my system. So yeah, that was quite dumb. Anyway, maybe I can show you also is directory like so. You can check without using the stat syscall that if it's a directory or file, as I say, so entry, and you say d type, and then you can end it with some flag, and I think it's like, well, I forgot, readdir, I think it is dt, so for directory type, I guess. So as you can see, you can check for if it's a directory, a FIFO, a regular file, stuff like that. So let me just quickly showcase this to you. So for all of them, it's zero except for bar, which is a directory. And so for this directory, it says like four because it's the value of the flag. Yeah, that's about it. The readdir function returns null when it either finished reading all the entries or it had an error. So what you do generally to check if there was an error is you set erno to zero, and then you check if erno is still zero after the loop. So in my case, it's good, no error. If you want to reuse, if you want to reread the directory without closing it, then opening it again. There is a very similar to the file API, where if I copy this, let me remove erno to make it a bit clearer. If I do this, of course, it will. Hop, Let me remove this actually. Like so. Yeah. Oops. Okay. Anyway, so it will only read it once, as you can see, even though I have two loops because, well, it finished reading it here. But you can, like file, you can do file, you can do rewind dir, and you give it the directory pointer, and it will put you back at the start. So you can iterate multiple times on it if you want. There is also a tell dir and a seek dir, which is again very similar to files, although it's a bit strange. So you can say entry index is equal to minus one. And then here, let's first print it to see what it does. And here you can say tell dir dir, which will tell you the position in the directory list, directory array, let's say. No, the directory entries array, something like that. And so you can see it's not regular indices. It's like, I don't know, probably something related to the system or something. But basically, if you call later seek dir to go at a specific entry, you have to reuse those numbers, not like 0, 1, 2, 3, you know, not regular indices. So in my case, I could say if entry index is equal to minus 1, then we can say entry index is equal to tell dir. We set it to an entry that is an entry index that is valid. And then here, instead of rewind dir, I could say seek dir. Then you give it the directory pointer and the entry index. And you can see that it will start at the second entry instead of starting at the first one. So yeah, that's mainly it for the functions that that you will use often. But while doing some research for this video, I discovered that there is a cool function called scandir, which allows you to put all the entries of a directory in an array, kind of like filtering them and sorting them without like manually iterating through it. Like it does a lot of the stuff for you if you need this. So the way this function is called scandir, and the way it works is you create an array of directory entry pointers, so like so, entries, and then it will return the size of this array, and you call scan dir with again just the name of the directory, so we could say foo, and then you give it a pointer to this array, so the address of entries, then the third argument I will explain later, and you need to give it like a comparison function. For now, let's just give it alpha sort. And so what alpha sort is basically string compare. Like, yeah, that's it. It will, so what scandir will do is it will iterate over all the entries in the directory, and then it will sort them using this function. So man scandir. You can see that it's very similar to like the quicksort or the merge sort function, where it just takes a comparison function that takes a directory entry, and it will return minus one, zero, or one, you know, like exactly like a string compare, but for directory entries. So if I then do a for loop to just quickly iterate over those, a++ printf, and we can again just print, we can say I and entries I d name, print the name of it. Yeah, and you can see that it sorted the thing for you, a b, b a, and then c. And what you can do as well, but that's a GNU extension, is there is a function called version sort. And it will sort version numbers for you. So here I have prepared a directory full of version numbers. And so if you give it, If you give this function to it, it will automatically sort it for you. And so it's a GNU extension, so you have to say define that. I think GNU source. That might not be correct. It is correct. So you can see that it sorted all the versions for you. And the third argument, I haven't used it, but basically it's quite simple. Scandir, it's just a filter. So I assume if it returns one, it will... well, actually, let's make sure I don't say terrible thing. Filter. Okay, so if filter returns zero, it won't be included in the list of directory. And if it returns one, it will be included. Just convenient for in our example, it would have been nice to ignore those two, like the dot and the two dot entries, things like that. Anyway, that's all I've got to say on directories. Hope this was a bit helpful. And see you in the next one.